Robin Hood. Now, you may have already deduced from the trailers or heard somewhere, this is a bit of a reinterpretation of the Robin Hood legend. Now, obviously, a decision like that is going to be met with mixed responses. Personally, I think we were due. The amount of film versions is in the 20s, I think. And yet, this is the only version I can think of that really takes a lot of chances with it. Also, to anyone out there who's vehemently against changing legends and the like, you're entitled to your opinion. I entirely respect your opinion and your right to have it, but I respectfully disagree. There are two things that we do with legends. We retell them, and we alter them. And usually, the altering leaves traces of our current culture in the new version. As an example, I read once that Maid Marian was not always part of the legend of Robin Hood. And that's something we consider to be an integral part of the legend. But yes, it's a reimagining in the vein of the new Sherlock Holmes. Taking a familiar character and doing something different with it. I can sort of segue from that into, yes, part of the reason I watched this was to satisfy my need for a dose of Mark Strong. I'm not kidding, my hand was beginning to shake. My addiction began when I watched Body of Lies and loved his character, his performance, everything about him in that movie. Since then I got to watch Sunshine and Sherlock Holmes, and I cannot get enough of the guy. I want to start by addressing some complaints I've heard. Now, I haven't actually watched Gladiator, but I've heard a lot about it, and I get the gist of the comparison. And yes, this is sort of a Gladiator light. It is not entirely as satisfying and focused as it could be, and given that we're giving it 140 minutes of our lives, frankly, should be, it's not entirely sure what it wants to be, and it definitely is not Ridley Scott's best work. With that said, I enjoyed it a lot. Even though the pace wasn't always fast, I was never bored. Another thing I've heard complaints of is that there is not enough action specifically in the first part of the movie. I disagree. I'd say the amount of action is appropriate, but I will concede that it doesn't last very long. It actually reminded me somewhat of Kingdom of Heaven. The action is very cool, at times downright awesome. I would say there's more action than there was in the Kingdom of Heaven. The camera work is great. In a lot of the battle sequences, or the bits leading right up to that, the camera really places you right in the action. We also get a couple of big, nice, wide shots. Also, this has, for my money, hands down, the most beautifully photographed arrow fire from bow ever. The film is largely realistic and authentic. They even work in some historical events that took place around that time. With that said, there are some Hollywood cliches, of course. The cast is fantastic, and everybody delivers a stunning performance. Whenever it goes for it, this is very exciting and intense. The sense of humor is really good. Only a few jokes fall flat. It is, of course, always quite amusing when Hollywood professes that one of their movies contains the actual story, you know, what really happened. Okay, I'm gonna wrap this one up, and after that there'll be a brief section in which I answer, with as few spoilers as possible, questions that people might have concerning this movie. All in all, not Ridley's best, but you can tell that it's him. It's still quality work. I'd recommend it to any fan of Ridley Scott or anyone in the cast, as well as any fan of the Robin Hood legend, provided they can deal with it not being the presentation that they remember. Now, for anyone who doesn't want a reimagining, I haven't seen a lot of them. I can imagine the Errol Flynn one is really, really good, and other than that, I hear that the Costner one is a lot of fun, as long as you don't need your Robin Hood to be able to speak with an English accent. Okay, so here's where I'm gonna get into a relatively spoiler-free rundown of some things that I can imagine people might want to know before watching this movie. First off, the legend stuff. Yes, Robin Hood is in this, and he is the lead character. not an awful lot has changed with him. Yes, Maid Marian is in this, although she has a different personality than we're used to. Yes, Little John is in this, but there is no stick fight between him and Robin. Yes, Will Scarlet is in this. Yes, Friar Chuck is in this. Yes, the Sheriff of Nottingham, Richard the Lionheart, and Prince John are in this. Again, not entirely the way you remember them. Okay, that's it for the legend. So, you may have heard the rumors about the Magna Carta being in this, so I'm just gonna give a one-word response, yes or no, for anyone wondering. Ready? Yes, the Magna Carta is in this. That's it for my spoiler-free review. I hope you enjoyed it.